Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the bride. That's a sign of good luck. Please be seated. Jeff and Caitlin, today you marry your best friend. The one that you've chosen to support, encourage, and give yourself to all the days of your life. Today, you marry the one that you love.
Now take a moment.
And look around. Capture this moment in your memory. The love that you have for each other in each other's eyes. And remember the faces of your family and friends, all of whom are gathered to not only witness this ultimate exchange of love, but to support you on your life's journey. And Jeff and Caitlin want to welcome all of you to this celebration of their love for one another. Each of you has given something very special to their lives, and your love and encouragement will forever be appreciated. Thank you for sharing one of life's happiest moments with them, and may you be as an important part of their tomorrows as you are of their todays. Now, happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. It's those little things that are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands, and it's remembering to say, "I love you," at least once a day. It's finding ways of keeping that courtship alive and standing together and facing the world. It's forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is not about looking for perfection in each other. It is about cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, gratitude, and a sense of humor. Marriage is choosing that one special person to walk through life together. Marriage today is a choice, freely, openly, and gladly made, of a life companion, a partner, and a friend. And today, you are publicly making that choice. You are choosing one another to journey together as life companions. Now, Dr. Seuss said, "We're all a little weird, and life is a little weird. And when we find someone whose weirdness is compatible with our own, we join up with them, and we fall in mutual weirdness, and we call it love." And when I asked Caitlin and Jeff what they liked about their relationship, they have the same answer. That they never have to wear a mask around the other person, allowing them to be their true goofy selves. It was noticeable on their first date, when they sat right in the very front row of the movie theater, with Jeff talking periodically throughout the film, but not in a way that Caitlin found annoying. And right off the bat, they shared this unexplainable level of comfort. In fact, they were so at ease with each other that the next day, they went on a second date to the Avalon Park in Stony Brook, and they stopped to pick out a Christmas tree together. And then a week later, Jeff took Caitlin upstate to Shroom Lake to celebrate her birthday. Caitlin was different than all the other girls that he had met, and she was a breath of fresh air. And in addition to be able to being himself around her, Jeff was drawn to her kindness, which extends to everyone that she meets. And he especially admires the way that she speaks about her family, her friends, and her students. And he sees the way that she cares about them, and it makes him fall more in love with her. And of course, Caitlin thinks that Jeff is pretty great too. After all, he's her best friend. And it's a little funny that one of Caitlin's favorite memories is the time that they were playing disc golf up in Vermont and some guy accidentally broke her car window. And although she was initially understandably upset, Jeff was so sweet, doing everything he could to make the situation better. And as they wrapped bags around their window in the rain, Jeff kept making her laugh, kind of like right now. And at that moment, she realized that she was having so much fun, and she was so grateful to have found such a wonderful person in her life. And it works out perfectly that they share the same interests, and they're always up for an adventure. Whether it's going for a hike, or getting up at 3:30 in the morning to make a hot air balloon festival. But to be honest, they have just as much fun fishing on the boat, or simply cooking a meal together at home, as long as they're doing it together. And there's no doubt that Caitlin and Jeff have found their partner in each other. So Jeff knew that there was one thing to do. A year later, on a December trip back to Shroom Lake for Caitlin's birthday, he and Cait were in the middle of a game of rummy when he asked her if she wanted a present. And she said sure, because who doesn't want a present? And with that, he presented Caitlin with a special book that he had created with her favorite Dr. Seuss quote inside, along with a ring, and he asked her to be his wife. And Caitlin and Jeff, may your life together be filled with health and happiness and wonderful memories as you accomplish all of your dreams. And continue to be a little weird, because that's what makes life interesting. And always remember how lucky you are to have fallen in love with your best friend. So Jeff, do you take Caitlin to be your wife? Do you promise to walk together through life as partners and best friends? And that you shall always do your best to love and accept her exactly the way that she is. And you promise to be with her through life's changes and to nurture and strengthen the love between you until the end of time. I'm trying to go as fast as I can for you guys. Do you, Caitlin, take Jeff to be your husband? Do you promise to walk through life as partners and best friends? And that you shall always do your best to love and accept Jeff exactly the way that he is. And you promise to be with you through life's changes and to nurture and strengthen the love between you until the end of time. Now they're going to read the vows that they have written to each other.
Where are those pop-up pens?
This starts to go, let me know.
I love you. I love you, Jeff. You are my best friend, my adventure buddy, my favorite person, my crush, my forever friend. When we first met, I was instantly comfortable with reaching by you. I love that I could truly be myself with you, as crazy and goofy as I may be, and you love me all the more for it. You are my calm, the person who keeps me smiling and laughing. Your thoughtfulness, determination, and patience are things that I cherish. You know that I'm the most indecisive person on earth, but one thing that I've never been uncertain of is the love that I have for you. Today, I stand here making the easiest decision of my life, becoming you. I promise to be true to you, to cherish you, and to share my thoughts, hopes, and dreams with you. I promise to create a life for us of unexpected and strange adventures. I promise to always be open and honest with you. I promise to not only grow old with you, but to grow with you every day. I promise to be present, to be supportive, enthusiastic, and loving. I promise I will always be your partner in life, whether you need someone to talk to, laugh with, be on, or just someone to play disc golf with. But most importantly, I promise that I will never stop loving you. You are my once-in-a-lifetime love, and today begins our fairy tale that has no end. You truly are my life, my love, my always. Standing here today, I can tell you without any uncertainty, I did, I do, and I'll always choose you. I love you. Mm-hmm.
On our first date, we saw Arrival at Regal Theater and Kicked Back in the Pioneers in Silence for 116 nights. This was an ideal first date for me as my propensity for silence. That being said, A 3 hour non-stop conversation with the banner next door to follow the cycle info. The next day, you helped me pick out a Christmas tree from my house, and now here we are, a little over 53 million seconds later. Many of those seconds in between have been the most rewarding of my life. From the beginning, you met me with an open and honest heart, and I love you for that. You don't pretend to be everything that you're not, and I love you for who you are. Your wonderless and zeal for life is infectious, and it holds me beyond myself and out of my own way. I look into your eyes, and I see a future. Love it. As we move forward, our future becomes the present, and the present our past. I vow to communicate with integrity. For this is what you say, and be honest and loving with my words towards you. I promise not to take things too personally, and to always take time to look at things from your point of view. I will do my best to avoid making assumptions in my own small window of perception, to be thoughtful of your views and consider your feelings. I promise to never stop working to make our marriage stronger and more resilient. I will do my best to strengthen and nurture with love and kindness. I promise that you will never be alone. I will always be able to support you without judgment. Keep your good times in the bad. Finally, I will never stop telling you that I love you. But more importantly, I'll never stop showing you that I love you. Standing here today, I have a humble heart that is full of gratitude. Although this ceremony is a symbol and a celebration of our commitment to each other, my love has self-manifested itself through our adventures and shared experiences. Looking in your eyes, I see love. I love you too.
These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love, that are holding yours on your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside of you, as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fill your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe away tears from your eyes, both tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands, when even wrinkled with age, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you that unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Now the wedding ring is a symbol of an unbroken circle of love. For love freely given has no beginning and no end. And once these rings are given and received, they seal that promise that you've made with one another. And may these rings always be a loving reminder of the ties that bind you together as husband and wife. Caitlin, with this ring, I give you my heart. I promise from this day forward, you shall not walk alone. May my arms be your shelter, and my heart be your home. And Jeff, with this ring, I give you my heart. I promise from this day forward, you shall not walk alone. May my arms be your shelter, and my heart be your home. And Jeff and Caitlin will now take part in a tree planting ceremony. And their mothers have brought soil from their childhood backyard. And Caitlin and Jeff will join the soils now together to plant this tree to symbolize the root of their relationship and the continued growth of their love, as they become each other's family today. Love is the essence of every human experience. Love enriches our experiences and fills our lives with meaning. It gives us a firm base from which to grow, to learn and change. And let your relationship and your love for each other be like this tree that you've planted here today. Let it grow tall and strong. Let it stand during harsh winds, rains and storms. Looks like it's doing a good job so far. And like the tree, may your marriage be resilient, whether any changes of daily life and passage of time. And as you continue your journey together, I ask you to remember this advice. The key to love is understanding, as is the little things that say so much by themselves. The key to love is forgiving, to accept each other's faults and pardon mistakes. The key to love is sharing your good fortune as well as your bad together. The key to love is giving, giving without the thought of return, but with the hope of a simple smile, and by giving in and never giving up. And with this promise and declaration of love, it is my pleasure, through and accordance the laws of New York and by the virtue of authority vested in me by the state of New York, to pronounce you husband and wife and make this the bride. Some dry weather.